Well. You guys, I don't even know what to say anymore. Look at the title. I'm not. I can't. This episode was so bad. You have to be 3 years old to know this is bad. This is how bad this shit is. Why the fuck? Okay, I'm literally at the start of my video. You probably guys already saw this. I already put your discussion as advised and everything. This shit is just retarded. This shit. I can't believe whoever fucking made this episode. It took three professional fucking writers. I know this were bad. To make this one fucking stupid episode. And no, I'm not doing a review or a reaction to SpongeBob, what's called, A Pal for Gary. I'm not doing that shit. I'm just not. It just scares me that this is almost as bad or worse than one course meal. There is an episode out there that is better than this. I mean, shout out to Mr. Enter. Let me just skip start to this video and everything. And thanks for watching.
Now, when SpongeBob does something so horrendous, they tend to do it only once. Well, needless to say, I was wrong. Dead fucking wrong. I was originally going to review Little Yellow Book this week because it proves that the writers have found a way to make Squidward unlikable, even after everything you guys saw last week. I will get to it eventually, but just like with SpongeBob You're Fired, I found something so heinous that I needed to kill it as soon as possible. Actually, I wanted to review it right away because I don't ever want to watch this episode again. Over the past week, I've been trying to figure out how many atrocities that SpongeBob has. If you're wondering, we're currently up to 118. I have recently marathoned the entirety of Season 8. And I found something that I didn't thought exist. I thought that it couldn't exist. Let me put this as bluntly as possible. At its core, Pet Sitter Pat is a shitty ripoff of A Pal for Gary. No joke. It even has the exact same team of quote-unquote writers. Hell, we just might want to call it a shitty remake of A Pal for Gary. The most hated and infamous episode of the whole show. What are we waiting for? Let's get started. This episode. So it starts with SpongeBob getting a letter inviting him to his grandmother's birthday party. He's excited to go, but ends up tripping over Gary. Then he remembers that someone needs to watch him. Since he's going to be gone for an entire day, it is more believable than his paranoia from A Pal for Gary. And that probably refers to exactly what pisses me off about this episode. It seems like the writers wanted to improve A Pal for Gary, but completely missed what the fuck the problem was.
Yeah, exactly!
SpongeBob is incredibly believable in this episode, but I'm getting ahead of myself. Believe it or not, this episode is a Patrick's a Prick episode, and the absolute worst in that category.
Oh my god, yeah! Yes.
And Smooth Jazz at Bikini Bottom? You haven't seen nothing yet. SpongeBob comes to Patrick and finds him mumbling to his reflection because he thinks it's a real person. Whatever. Then SpongeBob asks Patrick to take care of Gary.
You're going off the grid? Don't worry. I know what to do.
Why would you assume that?
Trusting my best pal to watch carefully over Gary while I'm gone.
And then he drops Gary on the ground.
Yeah, the fuck?
You probably already see where this is going.
Yep.
SpongeBob gives Patrick a list of things he has to do in order to take care of Gary.
Really hate Patrick this episode, is more guys. Interested I really do. It's so
SpongeBob leaves, saying he will be back by 10.
SpongeBob, don't you trust me? I am the most responsible guy you know.
Fight me. SpongeBob leaves, and Patrick tries to read the list. Unfortunately, he holds it upside down, thinks that SpongeBob has terrible handwriting, and throws it away. He then offers to take Gary for a walk, but indigestion catches up with him, and he rushes to the bathroom. And then he ends up staying there until late at night. When he gets out, Gary is obviously weak and hungry. Patrick tears open the food bag and eats the entire thing right in front of Gary. Did I tell you how much I despise these writers' guts? Then Patrick goes looking for more food while he cuts a SpongeBob at his grandmother's.
Self, which gets
me
back
to. She made him a special gelatin snail, prompting him to be worried about Gary. He uses the phone, and Patrick says that Gary is absolutely fine. Guys, just because I can believe SpongeBob's ignorance and his concern does not mean this episode is better. It's actually worse, because you've used this as an excuse to make Gary's treatment more cruel. You don't believe me? When SpongeBob tells Patrick to give Gary a bath, things get
really do, like, I.
Bad.
No joke.
Patrick holds Gary underneath the smelly pits, claiming that Gary smells bad. And then he turns on the sink. Then he fills the sink with snail food.
Gotta get the water to stay in there somehow.
I am this close to snapping right now. This fucking close.
Hello, Gary. We don't eat the bath. We get in the bath.
What?
You guys already know that I absolutely hate these writers. I despise their guts. Want them blacklisted. Zeus Service is clearly some kind of sadistic asshole that lives in a world of insane troll logic. Richard Purcell is just a plain sadist. And Casey Alexander, he's a complete idiot.
Damn,
Casey, you're a fucking moron. Back to the episode where Gary's food has dissolved. He attacks Patrick and runs off. I'm not entirely sure, but I kind of think they were supposed to see Patrick as the protagonist. SpongeBob calls up again.
Get it, SpongeBob! I get it!
Please hit him with something. Thank you.
Patrick
ends up in a bathtub himself and ends up breaking the shower head.
The fuck?
He almost tells Gary that it's time for his bath.
Patrick?
Shut up, Patrick!
Trick the snail. You gotta be smarterer than him.
What exactly did you have in mind?
Hey, buddy, I got something cool to show you.
Patrick, what is that?
It's the opposite of a wet, watery bath.
What do you mean by that?
Where the hell did he get that rain door?
Jesus fucking Christ! Is this supposed to be funny? No, no, no. They cannot be that stupid. The only other reason that I can think of Patrick having a fucking flamethrower is that they're trying to show how dangerous he is to Gary, which they already fucking did.
Doesn't that look fun?
I have nothing. I have literally
This episode, man.
Look, this goes beyond stupidity.
Oh my god.
You made a character too stupid when they're doing something that could not conceivably have a positive outcome. But they're way past the point of no return.
This character is a monster. Not even retardation, it's just passion.
Yeah, pretty much exactly like Puffy Fluffy. This thing needs to be locked up before it can cause any more pain and suffering. His charming stupidity from the early seasons has morphed into the most hated character on the show for me. More than SpongeBob, more than Karen, and even more than Mr. Drivey to Suicide Crab.
Exactly.
Make up your mind. Is it water or fire?
Lock him up? No. This thing needs to be killed before he can cause anyone any harm ever again.
Exactly.
He chases Gary down with a hose and bathes Gary on the spot. Gary's sounds of agony make it sound like he's in very real pain.
That wasn't so bad, though, was it?
You chased him down with a fucking flamethrower. You brain dead burdens everyone around
you. Where did he get that?
And a can of food falls on Gary because our writers think that pure pain is funny.
Oh, now I gotta dry you off. Fortunately, I couldn't find any salt.
That kills snails, you fuck. I know that that's the fucking joke, but I don't care. It's obviously not fucking funny. Incompetence almost killing someone's pet repeatedly is not fucking funny. So Patrick uses a hairdryer that hardens Gary. Yeah, as bad as a pal for Gary is, Gary makes it through relatively unscathed, the nightmares notwithstanding. He's in constant pain in this episode, and the camera just keeps holding on what Patrick just did to the poor guy. And because Patrick left all the waters running, the house begins to flood.
This
eventually gets Patrick to wake up.
Sheesh, Gary. If you wanted another bath, why didn't you just ask?
You know, I don't normally do this, but that line was so infuriating that we need to take a break. I've already shown you Casey Alexander's Twitter feed.
Guys, I can't.
It was so many nuggets of information. Like this one. Or this one referring to one course meal. Or this one. So Casey Alexander is currently a storyboard supervisor on Uncle Grandpa. Note to self, do an animated atrocity review on Uncle Grandpa in the very near future. As for now, Casey, this is to you. Arrogance and stupidity are the worst traits to have together. John Enter, come at me, bro. Now back to this atrocity that you had roughly one-third part in and don't understand why it was wrong.
Casey Alexander is so stupid.
This makes SpongeBob imagine that his own house is on fire, and he uses the phone again. Patrick answers it, and when they go under a water strain, SpongeBob finally figures out that something is wrong. He hurriedly ends his grandmother's party and rushes home. He opens the door to find his house destroyed, and then he finds Gary, okay, and reading a bedtime story to Patrick.
What?
Yeah, there's no explanation to why Gary would want anything to do with Patrick after he chased him down with a fucking flamethrower. Normally, pets wouldn't want anything to do with you if you forgot to feed them.
The fuck? Patrick
went above and beyond. Yeah, you know my saying, what I'm doing is wrong. I know it's wrong, but I'm gonna do it anyway. After a pal for Gary's universal scorn, the writers had to know that it was a terrible episode.
This is terrible.
Either didn't know, or they didn't fucking care. And after going through Casey Alexander's Twitter, I'm going with the latter option. If you're wondering why I'm taking this shit so seriously, it's because that I have a faint hope that I might be loud and abrasive enough to crack through their thick skulls and help them actually find a clue. But the more I watch, the more I realize that that's never going to happen.
Right?
These people are detached from reality.
It has to be this stupid. Really, like...
This tells me that they thought the only problem with the pal for Gary was SpongeBob's obliviousness. You know, not the sadistic cruelty that lasted throughout the entire episode, not the broken plot that took out of nowhere twists, not how horribly unfunny it was. I love it how Casey Alexander talks like he's a big shot with mountains of skill and experience, when all he's ever done is SpongeBob from season 4 onwards, and Uncle Grandpa. Casey, you're not an artist. I know we live in the self-esteem generation, but you're not an artist. You don't make art. You make crap. You have always made crap. The few miracles that
always,
just happen in the
credits
don't change that. You have no talent. Stop acting like you do, and maybe I'll have the slightest inkling of respect for you.
This was my home. All this pain and devastation.
Now, guys, let's get one thing straight. Fuck Casey Alexander, first of all. He calls himself a professional writer, guys. A professional writer is someone that knows how to write, and he calls himself a professional artist, which knows how to do things in under time limits and anything else, and calls it their best work, and they know it's their best work, when Casey Alexander, no, it's not. He puts someone, Jeremy Plankton, a character for a kids show, to suicide when he was supposed to be the antagonist. Number one. Number two, he got two other professional writers. They're not even professional writers. They're fucked up writers. Following what Casey Alexander said in his statement, he doesn't care. He just wants to do this show. He just doesn't care. He's a fucking asshole. I wish he'd just die today. I wish they would just get new people for this shit. They need the original writer back. That's what the real new original writer is coming to season 10, I believe. That's all I know. I don't even know when season 10 is coming out. I think I already came out. I don't know. I just heard rumors about it. Anyways, third thing, they ripped off a pal of for Gary and remade it into this bullshit. I couldn't do a pal for Gary. I had to do this shit because it was so bad. Like, you can't get this stupid. He literally got a fucking flamethrower, guys. I was fine. I was fine with the campfire shit. I was fine with this other fire crap with the chocolate bars. But no, I am not fine with anything beyond flamethrowers. Yes, Mr. Krabs had a flamethrower. That was funny. I don't know how, but it was just funny because it was unexpected. Patrick made it seem that he actually had something in his fucking back of his hand. It was a fucking flamethrower, guys. A flamethrower. How the fuck are you supposed to put that in that show with Gary? I mean, I can understand this and that, but don't make it as if it's like the worst thing you can put in an episode. He made an extra long and hard sentence so he could just put it out there for everybody to see. Yes, we all know what flamethrowers are. Some may not, some may know, but that's what a flamethrower is. He made it as if it wasn't even a thing. And you know what really gets me mad? How fucking Patrick said, oh, I have something dry and something unwet behind my back. And then after he flamethrowed him, Gary, he was like, oh, is this supposed to be a wet object or something? It is one of the most stupidest things I have ever saw in any cartoon. This is not the worst episode, though. Not even one course meal. No. I'll give you a hint on which episode this is. And it will be for 100 subscribe special. Alright? Subscriber special. You guys already probably know what it is, but some may not. This episode has one of the worst plot lines, one of the worst guilts, and I will give you this. It's a Patrick, a fucking prick, jerk, ass, motherfucking cunt, fuck, bitch, ass, little sucking dick, whore, slut, ass, fat ass, piece of shit, you could call it. That is what that episode remarks as, to as when SpongeBob is trying to be a good friend to him, and Patrick's trying to be an asshole to him. There's a bunch of episodes like that, but there's only one episode. Patrick is like that. And no, it's not stuck in the ringer. It's not stuck in the ringer. That's all for today, guys. I hope you guys liked. Subscribe. And subscribe for more, guys. Thank you for... See you later. Share and sub.
I wonder why you came with me.